Secrets of a Stylist. For those of you who don't know me, my name's Kim. I'm a fashion stylist. And for those of you who do, welcome back. I'm so excited to see you guys. I love you. If you're coming from another video, hello. I hope that you enjoyed that last one too. Okay, before I get to this video, if you guys like this video, remember to give it a thumbs up. That's how I know what types of videos you guys like, besides you telling me down in the comments and saying hello and telling me what country you're from. That's a great thing for me because then I do know that you guys love the basics. The basic videos really blow up on this channel, which is why I've chosen to do summer basics. Also, because I'm starting to get asked questions about it and I'm also looking for some of these pieces myself. Okay, so let's get right into the video, summer basics. Number one basic that I don't feel like you can live without in the summer is white runners. They have literally been trending forever and they are still trending now, but there is nothing better than the summer and putting on a fresh pair of white runners. You can wear them with a maxi skirt, with a pair of jean shorts, with a pair of khaki pants. I mean, literally everything. Okay, so here's the thing about white runners. If you have a pair in your closet, awesome, haul them out, but haul them out before you need to put them on and clean them. You don't have to get a new pair if you have a pair. You can just simply throw the laces in the washing machine. In fact, you can throw most of the shoes in the whole washing machine. I, in fact, did a video on how to clean your white runners. I'll link it down below so you can check that out. But to be honest, I just threw my Alexander McQueens and my Gucci's into the washing machine with a white towel and washed them, and they came out looking fantastic. It was super easy. So the splurge runner of the season, I think it has to be the white Chanel runner. I actually bought this one. I really like it. It's kind of like a dad runner. It's got a bit of netting. I love this shoe. I think it's fantastic. It's a splurge. Alexander McQueen, question is, are they still trending? They are. They're also a splurge. I have that runner. But there are so many other ones that don't cost that much. So if you don't want to spend that much and you're not really invested in the white runners, Converse has a great pair. Adidas has a great pair. Vans has a fantastic slip-on pair. Rothy's has an amazing slip-on white pair that is made from recycled water bottles. Love those. I also have those. Tell me down below, which are your favorite white runners? I want to know. Everyone else wants to know. Get a great pair that works for you. The second summer basic that I think that you need to have, that I actually know that you need to have, is a white collared shirt. Okay, so white collared shirts, what can you do with them? I have so many different types. I have silk ones, cotton ones, linen ones, because it's just a basic for your wardrobe. You can throw them on with a maxi skirt. You can tie them in a knot. You can wear them with a pair of jeans and look totally classic. High-rise jeans look like Jennifer Aniston, hair in a pony, you're good to go. A linen shirt, you can throw it over your bathing suit. Love it. Silk, dress it up at night with a pair of like leather or vegan leather pants. So fantastic. You need one. Splurge, I love this equipment one that I found. I actually own this one. It's got 3/4 length sleeves. The V is deep. The collar is small. It's cut really narrow. Great shirt. Basic white shirt everyone can wear, let's be honest. A save on this type of shirt, Lily Silk. I've actually worked with Lily Silk for years and years, and I actually throw their silk tops. Don't get mad at me, anyone who's like really into it, but I put them in the washing machine on a gentle, and then I hang them to dry, and my silks have actually been fantastic. I know you should probably dry clean them, but a lot of the time I do that and it works out. So anyway, if you guys are like gurus on this and you have any great instructions, let me know down below. Let all of us know in the care for a silk shirt. But that's what I've done, and I've always been successful, and mine have been fantastic. Number three, the third thing that you need is a pair of slip-on nude sandals. If you do not have a pair of nude sandals in your wardrobe for summer, you really do need a pair because they really help you to get out the door fast. So the trick with having the basics in your wardrobe, it's great to have all the fancy things, the pink dress, all these things, but if you really can't really get out the door often and build outfits if you don't have the basics, the nude sandals are a basic that you need. The splurge, I have the Hermes pair. I absolutely love them. I've had them for years. My daughter steals them from me all the time. Something to note, if you have sandals that you've worn the year before many years, take them into like a shoe guide. Have them polish them up. The Hermes ones are leather on the bottom, so they need to have like a coating put on. I'm gonna get that done. So it just kind of adds longevity to the life of the sandal and also makes them look fresh for the new season. So you don't actually have to buy a pair, you can just repair what you have. Okay, and then the save on those, there is a Steve Madden pair that look very similar, but there's so many. Birkenstocks are trending too. So the pair with the buckle, those are amazing. Get them in like a nude brown color, so fantastic. Throw on your white shirt, pair of jeans, and brown sandals, walk out the door, you're looking amazing. Okay, the next thing that you need on your summer basics list is a pair of black flats. I know I'm like stuck in the shoe department here, but the thing is, having the basic shoes is actually vital for your summer success. So a pair of black flats, splurge. Hermes, always a splurge. Valentino, I actually have the bow flip-flops. I know I always say don't wear flip-flops because it really ruins like a nice outfit, but these ones are kind of different. They have a bow, they have the studs on them, so they're great. I actually wear those with long dresses and I've worn them out to dinner and they look really cute. There is a pair of Chanel's that are to die for. I have a pair of Gucci flats. I've talked about this before. They totally suck. Don't buy those. For some reason, they're so flat. I flap like a duck when I walk and then I actually catch them on things and trip. It's so hideous. Anyway, and the save on that side, any black sandals that are in great shape that work for your foot. There's so many different amazing ones out there. So just find ones that you love. Any type of straps will do. Like I said, the Birkenstocks are trending right now. Ooh, Zara has a fantastic dupe of the Balenciaga flat sandal. So great. Check that out if that's your style. Anyway, I will leave a list of black sandals down below. Next is a sun hat. It is very important actually to find a sun hat before you're heading out on that day on the patio to the beach, to the pool, where you're like, crap, I don't have a hat. And now you're like putting on some ratty baseball hat, which totally works if you're wearing like a jean shirt and you're camping, just going somewhere like not fancy. So the splurge on these hats, any type of really, I like the wide brimmed hats are gorgeous. Any type of straw hat that you really love. If you're into hats, then splurge on it. Put a little extra money into it. I do that with my baseball hats. I actually love baseball hats. I have not actually splurged on a straw hat. There is a Jacquemot hat that I really like. It's more of like a casual hat, but I think it'd be so cute on a dock with, again, like just a tank top, jean shorts, bathing suit. I love that. But anyway, there's so many great ones. I was actually in Palm Beach this winter and I found one at H&M because I did need one. I found one at H&M, it was fantastic. I wore it, looked classy, I loved it. So it doesn't matter, find one that works for you. The next thing that you need in your summer wardrobe that is a basic is jean shorts. Okay, I know you're gonna be like, well, I'm too old for jean shorts. I know, I hear that sometimes too. So let's go with like a more dressy version. So there is a pair of paper bag jean shorts, or maybe if you're like, jean shorts aren't for me, or I just feel like you've grown past them or they're not dressy enough, like I get all these comments, or can I wear jean shorts? So go with a different version. The paper bag version this year, so, so cute. So I found a pair, I believe they're at Revolve. I think they're Blank NYC. Blank NYC fits a little bit small, so be careful with that. But I love this pair. I don't actually own them, but I actually think I'm going to purchase them. I think they're so cute. So body types that paper bag shorts work with. Rectangles look great on you. They're gonna give you a little bit of a waist. They're gonna give you some movement. Inverted triangles, this works for you. Again, it adds a little bit of volume. That's me. If you're an apple body type and you're carrying your beautiful tummy is one of your features that you maybe don't want a feature, they can work for you. It just depends on the short. So don't walk away from them. You just have to go in and try on a bunch or just order a bunch and send them back the ones that don't work for you. But sometimes they really work because they can actually be slimming because they kind of flare out at the waist and then it makes it look like your waist is going in. So they're not a bad short actually for most body types. I believe H&M and Zara also have fantastic pairs. I actually tried a pair on at H&M in Palm Beach and they were so cute. They were khaki. So khaki shorts, jean shorts, add a pair into your wardrobe. If you want to be a little more dressed up, the paper bag version. The next piece that you need in your summer wardrobe is the maxi dress. I'm currently wearing one right now. I love this one. I got this one at Anthropology in Palm Springs years ago. I wear it all the time. So this one is obviously a little busier. I like the V, I like the 3/4 length sleeves. I like that it's a wrap dress. Wrap dresses look fantastic on almost every body type. However, I'm gonna suggest stick with the basics because we're talking about the summer basics. This is not a basic because it's colored. It's nice to really kind of spend some money on some neutrals, but if you have and you want to spend some more money, yeah, buy a whole bunch of colors. I did. I have like a yellow and blue one. I got them at H&M. They're fantastic. The dress that I'm really in love with, there's one that I found. It's long. It's white. It is a splurge. I haven't actually bought it yet. I plan on buying it, but I'm going to wait to see if it goes on sale. The save version, a long white or black maxi dress are so fantastic to have in your wardrobe for summer. Imagine this. You've got a call. Your girlfriend's on the patio, they're having a barbecue, you're heading to someone's pool. Throw on a long white dress. 3/4 length sleeves, so great because if it gets a little cooler in the evening, you feel a little bit warmer. And it wraps around, you throw on your straw tote, you throw on your slides, black or brown, you are out the door looking so classy and fantastic. So I love a casual white or black, get a basic, a jean one, fantastic. And if you got a little more, go for color. So that maxi dress tail brings me into the next item that you need is a tote for summer. So again, there's so many different totes. I saw this really massive one. Actually, I put it on CityLine. A really massive green one. I thought it was really cool. That one was leather. It didn't cost that much. But I really think for summer, the best tote that you can get is a straw tote, because it really, again, adds to any summer outfit. And I think it's really easy. You can throw in a towel, bathing suit, water bottle, computer, whatever you're doing. Again, imagine your white, your black, your pink dress. You throw that on with a pair of sandals. It really adds to the outfit. It looks great. It's kind of got that breezy style. There's one that I really love. It's a splurge, but I really like this YSL one. It's black and straw colored stripes. So classy. Imagine that with a white t-shirt and a pair of jean shorts. I love that bag. I think it's fantastic, but there are so many that you can save on. There's a billion different stores that have these straw bags ranging from like $20 to up as to as much as you want to spend, but just get one that works for you. Trust me, you'll be very happy that you have in your wardrobe this summer. I have two more items that you need in your wardrobe. Stay tuned because these are important. The midi skirt. You need a great basic midi skirt. I'm gonna tell you why. I'm saying midi, it could be a maxi. I love, there's all these new ones with elastics. This one that I found at Revolve, it's actually floral. So I know we're talking about the basics, but I do feel like a floral midi maxi skirt in the summer is actually a basic. This one, imagine white tank top tucked in, black tank top tucked in, your slides, your straw bag, you're good to go. Like, it's absolutely gorgeous. I actually have a black one. I throw that one on again with the tank top. Sometimes I throw a jean shirt over it, tie it in a knot. It's a great thing to have. You can throw it over a bathing suit. You can wear it casually. You can dress it up. Again, splurge. I love this one at Revolve. Save. There are so many out there. H&M, Zara, secondhand stores, The Gap. Many, many different smaller retails. Check out your local boutiques, especially right now. I know I'm naming a lot of the big boutiques, but check out the local boutiques in your area, because I bet you there's so many fantastic smaller designers and small boutiques in your area that have beautiful pieces that would really work for you. The last piece that you need for summer is a pair of gold hoops. Now, I have an absolute favorite pair. I actually lost one when I was running and I'm so annoyed because these are my favorite. They're from a store called Corbo 119, which is in Toronto. And I'll tell you why I like them. They're the perfect size and they literally weigh nothing. They're hollow and so they don't pull on your ears. They are a splurge. I can't remember exactly how much they were, but around 500 maybe. Don't quote me on that. You'll have to look them up. I'll leave a link to them down below and a number for the store you can call. But they are by far the best gold hoops that I have ever found in all my journeys, simply because of the weight. There's a few other designers that I really love, but these ones, just the thickness, the style, personally, I love. But anyway, save. There are so many places out there that you can get really great quality gold hoops. Another designer, Accessories by Talia, she has fantastic gold hoops. I've worn hers before. I'll leave a link down below. Beautiful hoops. She's got really big ones that I love. A paper bag necklace. I love it. I wear it all the time. I'm not wearing it right now, but usually I do. Check those out. I deviate. I was talking about hoops. But anyway, there's a million different pairs. If your ears tend to get affected by not using real gold, try ones that are gold plated. Splurge versus save. There's a pair out there for you. Get a pair of gold hoops in your arsenal for summer. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Again, whenever you are watching this, tell me what you're doing when you're watching the video. I wanna hear. I try to like envision where you guys are. If you're having coffee, if you're having wine, if you're sitting on your deck, if you're whatever you're doing. And I wanna say hi to all those followers that really take the time to talk to me, because I get some great stories from you. And hi to my friends that have said I kept them company in long, dark days. I love you guys and I really appreciate that feedback. I am totally giving you all my energy and all my love. And I hope you guys have a fantastic day, and I will see you on the next video.